What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the Android app development series. So this is the series 4 where we are going to learn about how to design an Android app, like a how to theme an Android app more clearly. So I'm gonna go to the Android Studio. So now you can see from our last tutorial we have a button and we have also added a click for this button. So now I'm gonna go and remove this button and also going to the main activity and removing these codes again. Okay, now we have a blank activity. So what I'm going to do today is that I'm gonna design the theme for this Android app. So let's suppose we have a background image and according to that image we have to change the color of this action bar and this notification bar. So the first of all, we have to add the background image. So let's go to the text and we can see, so here is the relative layout which contain all other widgets inside it. So if you got something just like me, so now I have got the relative layout not in a particular way. So we have to arrange the codes according to their spacing. So all we have to do is simply press Ctrl Alt L and now you can see the code has been formatted. So again, in order to add a background, you have to type for Android then background, and inside that we have to add a drawable. So drawable, so at drawable slash, so which include images from the drawable folder. So let's go to the app, rest for resources, then drawable. So here is the drawable and it has no files. So all you have to do is that you have to move an image into the drawable folder. So in my case, I have a sample image which named background, right click, and now I'm copying that, right click on the drawable folder, pasting it over here. I'm not changing any names or anything, just pressing the OK. Now you can see in the drawable I have a background.png file. You can also use png, gif or gif, jpeg or many other, even psd files can be used here, but I would suggest going with the png format, that is really better. So if you want to add a custom background for the Android app, you should always go with the resolution of 540 as the width and 960 as the height, so that is really better. So in my case I have a sample image here. Now I'm gonna go and change the or add the background image here, so slash background. You don't have to add the extension for this background. So anyway, we have done with that. So all we have to do is just go to the values, then go to the styles. Now you can see here is a couple of options. If you want, we can also remove the action bar by just going to, so we can remove the action bar just going to the styles again, and we have to also, we have to simply type for app compact dot no action bar. Now when you're going to the activity main.xml, we can see there is no action bar is actually exist. So I wanna return it back again, so I'm adding light dark background. So we have the action bar again. Now I'm going to the colors.xml and adjusting the colors according to the wallpaper. Okay, so we have done. So that is for this quick tutorial. So if you guys enjoyed watching this video, definitely give it a big thumbs up. So tomorrow we are going to learn about how to create a splash and how to design the splash screen for the Android app. So the splash screen is nothing but the welcome screen, so that the user see when the user login or when the user start the Android app. So I hope you guys enjoyed watching this tutorial. So if you like this, definitely give it a big thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel if you haven't done before. So thanks for watching and I hope to see you in my next tutorial.